that had already had some longevity in God. I said, God, that's what I want. I've already been through everything. I've fainted over and over. Am I talking to somebody in here right now? I've given up over and over and over again. And then the Lord said to me, he said, the reason why you can't give up is because you got to leave legacy where there's death. See, those old saints, they taught us how to stay in God. They taught us how not to give up on God.
Yes.
I ain't talking about no DJ Cannon. I ain't talking about beautiful song, don't give up on God because he won't give up on you. He's able. I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about they had it in their spirit. That I'm not giving up on God. This whole thing tonight is to say, God, there are some people that are left. There are some people that's left that are ready to serve you. Remember what happened to Elijah? You know why Elijah lost his wife? Not because he ran from Jezebel. Elijah lost his right because he didn't believe there were some other people that had the same power he had. It wasn't about Jezebel. Jezebel played on his fakeness. She played on his weakness. And see, that's what's happened in a lot of you. The enemy has been playing on your weakness. He's been seeing where you're weak, and he's playing on that. He's monopolized that. Ever played the game of Monopoly? How you win, you put hotels and motels on that joker. You get all the property that you can. So when people pass your property, they got to pay you. And instead of some of you understanding that you, oh God, have been redeemed, that needs to be bought back. By the blood of Jesus, the enemy has been playing you and playing you, and you've been losing by paying him. But this is a night. This is hanging on the shoulders of revival. I don't know what was preached on the revival, but this is hanging on the shoulders of revival. I feel revival in here. I feel that you're going to call a revival in this city that is going to be world renowned. It's going to be like a revival. We saw the revival. A white man brought a revival to a part of Alabama. It was only supposed to be for 3 days, because that's what you do. You do 3 days revival, not to raise money, because people have been saying you've been doing stuff to raise money. You ain't doing stuff to raise money. You're doing stuff. You're doing stuff so the power can come back to Greenwood. God said, I just heard the Holy Ghost say, a revival's going to come to Greenwood. It's going to be through her hands, and it's not going to be 3 nights. It's not going to be 7 days. It's not going to be 14 days. It's going to affect this whole area. This whole area is dead of a word. It's dead. It's dead. It's dead of the word. You know why it's dead of the word? Because people have forgotten about Greenwood, and you have forgotten too. I'm just being a prophet in the city. That's what I'm being tonight. The Koshaya. But God said there's a revival coming because of my will. I sit here. My will sits here. And now everybody that's here tonight, you're going to take the will of God back to your homes. You're going to take the will of God back to your church, and it's going to sit there. Lift up your hands. I just want to release prophetically that every day that you fainted, God said, I'm adding double to your days. Every day that you said, I've given up, God said, oh, Shia. God said, I'm adding double to your days. Everywhere that you've seen lack, that you've seen shortage, God said, the days are no longer prolonged. that you're going to see greater than you've never seen in your life. Lift up your hands. Worship the Lord right there.